നമസ്കാരം, യുവ ഡോക്ടറിലേക്ക് എല്ലാ പ്രേക്ഷകർക്കും സ്വാഗതം. ഞാൻ നിഷ. നമ്മളോടൊപ്പം ഇന്നും പതിവ് പോലെ ഒരു ഡോക്ടർ ജോയിൻ ചെയ്യുന്നുണ്ട്. ഡോക്ടർ ഈമാൻ യൂസഫ് ഹുസൈൻ ആണ്, സ്പെഷ്യലിസ്റ്റ് ഇന്റേണൽ മെഡിസിൻ ഫ്രം സൗദി ജർമ്മൻ ഹോസ്പിറ്റൽ ഷാർജ. വെൽക്കം ടു ദ ഷോ ഡോക്ടർ. താങ്ക് യു സോ മച്ച്. അപ്പോൾ നമ്മുടെ പ്രേക്ഷകർക്ക് ഇന്ന് നമ്മൾ ഡിസ്കസ് ചെയ്യാൻ പോകുന്ന ടോപ്പിക് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് ഹൈപ്പർ ടെൻഷൻ ആണ്. എനിക്ക് തോന്നുന്നു യുഎയിലെ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ നമ്മുടെ ഒരു ലൈഫ് സ്റ്റൈൽ അനുസരിച്ചിട്ട് എല്ലാവർക്കും ഹൈപ്പർ ടെൻഷൻ, ഒരു 90% ആൾക്കാർക്കും ഹൈപ്പർ ടെൻഷൻ ഒക്കെ ഉണ്ടാവും അല്ലേ. സോ അതിനെക്കുറിച്ചായിരിക്കും ഡോക്ടർ സംസാരിക്കുന്നുണ്ടാവുക. താഴെ നമ്പർ സ്ക്രോൾ ഡൗൺ ചെയ്തിട്ട് യു ക്യാൻ കോൾ എനി ടൈം ആൻഡ് ആസ്ക് ഡൗട്ട്സ് ഡയറക്ട്ലി. സോ ഡോക്ടർ, വാട്ട് ഈസ് ഹൈപ്പർ ടെൻഷൻ ബേസിക്കലി?
ഹൈപ്പർ ടെൻഷൻ, because we don't want to speak medical terminology, we make it easy for the audience.
Yeah, better.
The hypertension, that mean increasing the blood pressure inside the vessels in our body.
Okay, so is that similar to like this BP, what we call BP?
Yeah,
that is same.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's basically hypertension is,
it is a blood pressure increasing the blood pressure. Yes.
Okay, which is usually measured by sphygmomanometer, that one.
Yes,
right?
You are good in this. Yeah,
thank you. So that is blood pressure nu parayana. So what are the types of blood pressure?
There is the hypertension, actually we are dividing the hypertension to two types.
Okay,
there is a primary hypertension or essential hypertension. This type it is unknown cause. Most of the cases they don't know the cause exactly for that, but genetic factor and environmental factor may play a role on this kind of hypertension.
Primary
hypertension. The other type of hypertension, it is secondary hypertension. That mean there is cause for this hypertension.
Okay,
cause this is like a minimum amount of people they have this secondary hypertension.
Okay, so
most common is primary or the essential hypertension.
So
yes,
these both types can occur any time in a lifetime, or it's like any,
yeah, in any lifetime they can occur, but hypertension more common in old people.
Okay,
yeah,
in all age groups.
Yes,
all right. So these are the main types of this thing.
There is another classification for the hypertension, but this is
the basic one.
It is detailed. Yeah.
Yeah, all right. So as you mentioned, what are the causes of hypertension?
For the secondary type of hypertension, we can say like most of the causes is kidney disease. It can be a cause of high blood pressure. And some people also, if they have some hormonal abnormalities in their body, also they can cause hypertension. Thyroid gland disease, it is one of the cause of the high blood pressure.
Okay.
And even some medications can cause also high blood pressure.
Okay, cholesterol is a reason for high blood pressure?
Yes,
it is, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so basically this is a genetic one. Can we tell hypertension
like risk factor for high blood pressure? We are saying that family history.
Okay.
If the patient have a family history of high blood pressure, this is one of the risk factor to get hypertension. And high cholesterol, this is one of the risk factor. Smoking, alcohol consumption, and even the food, the salty food.
Oh,
this is one of the risk factor of the high blood pressure.
Okay.
And the most important thing is also the obesity.
Obesity.
Yeah. Okay. So all these risk factor for high blood pressure.
Okay. So basically, if a person is having either cholesterol or if he is smoking continuously, what about alcohol?
Alcohol is one of the risk factors, yes.
It is, right?
Yeah.
So it can cause blood pressure again.
Yes.
Okay, what is the normal blood pressure range in a normal person?
See, the normal range, we can say less than 120 over 80.
Okay.
So in medical terminology, that 120, that is the systolic one. This is the upper one. The diastolic high blood pressure, it should be around 80 or less than 80. This is a normal blood pressure.
Okay, so when is a person, when we can say that a person is hypertension, like he's having hypertension?
The hypertension, we cannot say from the first reading that you have high blood pressure.
Okay.
But most of the patient with high blood pressure, they don't have symptoms.
Okay.
They discover hypertension accidentally. You will go to your doctor for another reason, and they will check your vitals. If you went to any clinic, usually before you see the doctor, they check your vitals. So they found that your blood pressure is high. From this time, they cannot say that you have hypertension. You need to check with your physician. He will check your blood pressure 2 or 3 times. Maybe he will give you another visit.
Oh.
And then he will decide if you have hypertension or no. So okay. from the first reading, we cannot say that you have high blood pressure.
Okay. So, it'll fluctuate continuously or it'll be constant?
Yeah,
for
some patients, they have fluctuation. Mm-hmm. They have high blood pressure, some people, they get high blood pressure with stress. But normal life, they don't have any high blood pressure.
Oh, okay.
So some people every day they have high blood pressure. Uh-huh. So it is different from person to person. Yes.
Okay. So stress is also a risk factor.
Yes.
All right.
Yes, for sure.
All right. So I guess nowadays everyone is under stress, because work, all this, and obesity, of course, because of junk food and all.
Yes.
How can we control it to a limit?
Actually, we need more education for people, and people, they should know that how much hypertension is serious for their life. And if we educate people and they know that how much hypertension it is risky for their life, they will take care about their health. Okay, because nowadays hypertension is just not only for adult, not only for old people. Now even young patients we are seeing, they have high blood pressure.
Okay.
As I told you, because of our lifestyle, and this old lifestyle and risk factor, it is more now than before.
Right. So as you mentioned, what can control the blood pressure? Prevention is better than cure, right?
Yeah, the prevention, yes, is better. First, we are preferring the lifestyle change.
Okay.
Lifestyle change, that means you have to make sure that you are eating healthy food.
Okay.
No salty food. And if you are smoking, try please just to quit smoking. And reduce alcohol consumption.
Okay.
The obesity, we need regular exercise. Always I'm advising my patient to do regular exercise and to reduce their weight, because this is one of the most important things to control your blood pressure. If you are reducing weight, you will reduce your blood pressure with that.
Okay. Normal cardio exercise you prefer?
Yeah.
Okay, that's enough.
Yeah.
All right. Appo endalum idokkiyana nammude endana oru control cheyanulla control measures nu parayunnathu. Appo adinu shesham nammude prekshakalodu orikkal koodi orumbikkana thaale number scroll down cheyyunnathu 0529611333 nalla number like aanu ningalku vilikkendathu. Appo vilikkanengil theerchayayittum high blood pressure enna vishayathine kurichu allengil hypertension enna vishayathine kurichu endu samshayangalkkum doctorinodu samsarikkavunnathaanu. So doctor, coming back to the after effects of hypertension, if a person is having hypertension, is there any symptoms that he can understand that he is having hypertension?
See, this is good question, because most of patients, they don't have symptoms.
Okay.
You can say 90% of patients with hypertension, they don't have symptoms.
Okay.
Some they experience some symptoms like headache, and some they come with tiredness.
Okay.
And some may experience also nosebleed.
Nosebleed.
Yes.
Okay.
And this is one of the symptoms of the high blood pressure.
Okay. How about nausea? We feel dizziness.
Not nausea,
sometimes.
But dizziness. Some people, they came here and they say that I feel dizzy for a few days.
Okay.
This is one of the signs of the high blood pressure also.
All right. Coming to the management and the treatment of hypertension.
Yeah.
So if a person is identified that he is having hypertension, what he should do?
He should go to his physician first.
Okay.
The physician, he will guide you. And he will tell you what to do exactly. Because before we are treating the high blood pressure, we need to do some blood tests, we need to do some investigations to make sure that is it essential hypertension or there is another cause of this high blood pressure.
Okay.
If we exclude the secondary cause, then we will start the management according to the reading of the blood pressure.
Okay.
Because some patients, they have a very high blood pressure, they need some patient with lifestyle only, they may cure their blood pressure.
Okay.
Some patient, no, we need both type of management, and I will talk about this.
Okay.
If there is two part of management of high blood pressure, we can say that non-pharmacological treatment and pharmacological treatment.
Okay.
The non-pharmacological treatment, that means the most important things is a lifestyle change, as we mentioned in the beginning. If you reduce your weight, you make sure that you are eating healthy food, you are doing exercise regularly, and you quit smoking, you reduce your alcohol consumption, this it will help you to control the blood pressure.
That is when the patient is having a little
Yes, some patient with this management, they become okay.
Okay.
The other type, that is the pharmaceutical or the pharmacological management, this is for high blood pressure, which is not treated by non-pharmacological method. This is a lot of medications, and this it will be decided by your physician.
Okay, so that will be basically with tablets, medicines.
Yes. there is a lot of medication for high blood pressure.
Okay. If a person starts taking the medication, like at a particular time, should he continue till like it's a lifetime medication? Or?
This is also, it should be decided by your physician.
Okay.
To see if this hypertension, is it just, it is a hypertension, very high blood pressure, what is the cause of this blood pressure, is it secondary to other causes, or is it primary hypertension? Some blood pressure or hypertension, if it is secondary to any reason, we treated that reason, it will become okay. Mm-hmm. But most of patients, they take any medication for high blood pressure for a long period.
Okay. So, this medication, once started, as I mentioned, he can stop it at if he's reducing the BP, then he can stop it?
But not the patient by himself.
Uh-uh.
Always I'm saying to the patient, don't stop your medicine by yourself. Go to your physician and show him your readings, mm-hmm. and he will review your labs and everything. Mm-hmm. And he will tell you if you can stop your medicine or no. Because mm-hmm. many patients, they are not compliant to their medication. They stop it by themselves. And this is not good because... maybe they will get very high blood pressure, even higher than the one it was before the management.
Okay. So if a person is under medication, still can he get hypotension in between? Like if he's regularly taking medicines,
yeah.
But still if under stress, like maximum stress, can he get hypertension again?
Hypertension, you mean it will be more exaggerated?
Yeah.
Yes, yes. For the hypertension, there is emergency for the hypertension.
Okay.
So that always a hypertensive patient, we need to tell him about the sign, the symptoms which make him go to the emergency immediately if he fell.
Oh, like so if he is taking medicines on a daily basis,
yes.
he can get BP fluctuations
yes,
in between.
Yes.
So in that case, what he should do? He should go
yeah,
to the emergency.
During that time, if he felt like a severe headache or severe weird dizziness or any symptoms, he should go to the emergency immediately.
Oh, all right. So coming back to the after effects, like what can be the after effects of having hypertension? If a person is having hypertension, what can be the risk he can get in later on?
You mean the complication?
Yeah.
This is good. See, the problem of hypertension, it can affect any part in our body.
Okay.
It can start from the top, from our brain.
Oh.
It may cause stroke. And it can affect our eyes.
Okay.
Okay. It can affect hearts.
Okay.
Like heart attack, heart disease.
Mm-hmm.
Also our kidneys.
Okay.
Even our legs, the peripheries. It affects even the vessels in our legs.
Oh.
So many complications can happen because of high blood pressure.
Okay.
That's why always if patient has high blood pressure, he should be careful and he should take his medication as ordered by his physician.
Okay, so the complications, once a person is having a complication, later on can he come back to his normal life?
Some complication it may be treated, but
some
no.
Difficult.
Yeah, it is difficult to treat.
Ma'am, same like hypertension, the blood pressure, lowering the blood pressure is also an issue in most of the people, right?
Hypotension, yes.
Hypotension it is?
Yes.
Oh, all right. So what is the range for hypotension?
Hypotension, it is different from person to person.
Okay.
According to your normal. Some patients, their normal blood pressure, it is, say, like 90 over 60.
Oh.
This is all their life. Sometimes,
okay.
Some patients like that.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
Some patient 120 over 80, if it become less than this, they will feel some hypotension.
Okay.
So this is variation between people worldwide.
Okay.
But in general, some medication of hypertension may cause also hypotension.
Okay.
So your physician, he will teach you about the symptoms
mm-hmm.
of hypotension and to be aware that if you get hypotension, what to do.
Okay. All right. Appo endayalum prekshakarodu orikkal koodi ormippikkatte. Tha number scroll down cheyyunnathu 0529611333 nalla number like vilikkanengil hypertension enna vishayavumayittu bendappetta ningalude endu samshayangalkkum oru pariharam kittunnathaanu allengil adumayittu related aayittulla ningalude samshayangalkku oru endana oru ningalude doubtukal theerchayayum doctorinodu neerittu samsarikkavunnathaanu. So doctor, what else we have to know about hypertension?
Hypertension, we need to know that when and how to control our hypertension.
Mm-hmm.
Yani lifestyle change with medication, this is a perfect thing to make it.
Mm-hmm.
And as we said that, don't stop your medicine by yourself. This is important things.
All right.
And if people becomes friendly with their disease, they will get rid from it. But if you try to become against it, it will become more difficult to treat it.
All right. Some people in the morning time, when they wake up, after waking up, like for 2-3 hours, they'll be having some shivering. some kind of dizziness, they won't be able to drive,
yeah.
they won't be able to sign the papers like that. Is that because of hypertension?
Not exactly because of hypertension. Maybe they have another issue.
Okay.
But they should go to the physician. That's why I told you when they go to the physician, they will do for them a lot of investigations to see mm-hmm. what is the causes of this dizziness. Because even dizziness, it is the hypertension is not the only cause of dizziness. There is another causes of dizziness also, mm-hmm. and feeling of blurring vision and in this
blurring
many
vision.
Many things yes can cause these symptoms.
Oh,
so
right.
we cannot say any patient with dizziness that means he has hypertension.
Mm-hmm. As you mentioned earlier, there are two types of this hypertension. So both can be controlled or treated in the same way. The
yes.
primary one
yes.
and the second one was
the essential and essential. The secondary hypertension. Yeah,
yeah. Both
of them
can be
either with medication or with lifestyle or both together. Lifestyle and medication.
All right, we have a caller yes. with us, doctor. Hello.
Hello.
Yes. Good evening, Arana.
Good evening. Abraham.
Sorry.
Abraham.
Abraham. Abraham. Paranjolo. Doctor, some sir. Yeah.
Okay. Good evening, doctor.
Good evening. Hi, Abraham. How are you?
Good, fine. Doctor, one of my question is, one of my aunt, she is actually a cancer survivor. So for the last 17 years, she was in the home. Yes, she never go outside anywhere. So right now, she was showing some kind of depression. That means suddenly angry to even to her husband and even to her kids and grandkids. So if doctor is any medical treatment, I mean, shall we give any kind of tablets to reduce his tensionized process?
Okay, I couldn't hear his question.
One of his friends, she was he or she?
She
was having
cancer.
She was having cancer. Mm-hmm. She's a cancer survivor.
Years, she was in the home.
Mm-hmm. 17 years she was in the home. Okay.
So that causes him a depression mode. So
okay, that's, that caused her
showing quick angry to her husband, to her kids.
Is it because of hypertension?
She was angry.
No. This is, you should take her to a psychiatrist and he will evaluate her because heart disease is not an easy disease. For sure, she will feel depression, she will feel anxious, and she will feel angry for everybody around her. So the proper way, just please take her to any psychiatrist and physician also. They will check her medical condition and they will guide you properly.
She's mentioning that it's not because of hypertension most probably. Maybe you can take her to a psychiatrist. That's the best thing you can do. Yeah.
First, take her to the physician. He will
okay.
do blood test
uh-huh.
and he will exclude the organic reason for this. And then he will send you to the psychiatrist to help her to become okay, inshallah.
All right, Abraham.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Take care. So, ma'am, I should ask you this, I guess. Hypertension and anger, like anger, does it have any connection?
Anger, we can say anxiousness, yeah. Some people, yes, if their blood pressure become very high, they become not well.
Mm-hmm.
So they feel some kind of anxious, they become anxious and they become irritable a little bit also.
Okay, so if a person is having hypertension, he can be having mood swings maybe,
yeah.
he can get high, like angry so fast, like that?
Yeah.
Uh-huh, all right. Appa endalum nammodoppam oru caller koodi join cheyyunnundo nu. Hello? No. ഓൾ റൈറ്റ് എന്തായാലും നമ്മുടെ പ്രേക്ഷകരുടെ സംശയങ്ങൾക്കും അല്ലെങ്കിൽ എന്താണ് നമ്മുടെ കുറച്ച് ഹൈപ്പർടെൻഷനെ കുറിച്ചുള്ള കുറച്ച് കാര്യങ്ങളും ഒക്കെ നമ്മുടെ പ്രേക്ഷകരിലേക്ക് എത്തിക്കാൻ കഴിഞ്ഞു എന്ന് നമ്മൾ വിശ്വസിക്കുകയാണ്. എന്തായാലും നമ്മൾ ഇപ്പോൾ ഈ ഒരു എപ്പിസോഡ് വൈൻഡ് അപ്പ് ചെയ്യുകയാണ്. താങ്ക് യു സോ മച്ച് ഡോക്ടർ ഫോർ ബീയിങ് ഹിയർ വൺസ് അഗെയിൻ ആൻഡ് ഇറ്റ് വാസ് വെരി ഇൻഫോർമേറ്റീവ് ആൻഡ് ഇൻട്രസ്റ്റിംഗ് സെഷൻ.
താങ്ക് യു സോ മച്ച്. താങ്ക് യു ടു ഓൾ ദ സ്റ്റാഫ് ഹിയർ.
താങ്ക് യു സോ മച്ച്. നമ്മളിപ്പോൾ പോവുകയാണ്. ഈ ഡോക്ടറിൻ്റെ ഇന്നത്തെ എപ്പിസോഡ് അവസാനിക്കുന്നു. ഹൈപ്പർടെൻഷനെ കുറിച്ചിട്ടുള്ള നിങ്ങളുടെ കുറച്ച് തെറ്റിദ്ധാരണകളും കുറച്ച് കൺഫ്യൂഷൻസും ഒക്കെ മാറിയിട്ടുണ്ടാവും എന്ന് വിചാരിക്കുകയാണ്. അപ്പോൾ നമ്മളെ കണ്ടോണ്ടിരുന്ന എല്ലാവർക്കും ഒരിക്കൽ കൂടി നന്ദി അറിയിക്കുകയാണ്. മറ്റൊരു ഫ്രൈഡേയിൽ ഇതേ സമയം യുവർ ഡോക്ടറുമായി നമ്മൾ വീണ്ടും തിരിച്ചെത്തുന്നതായിരിക്കും. ടിൽ ദെൻ ദിസ് ഇസ് നിഷ സൈനിങ് ഓഫ് ഫ്രം യുവർ ഡോക്ടർ ഫ്രം എൻടിവി യുഎസ്.
ജനങ്ങൾക്കൊപ്പം, വാർത്തയ്ക്കൊപ്പം, നന്മയോടൊപ്പം എൻടിവി യുഎഇ ടു ദി വേൾഡ്.